Hi and welcome to this video. In the last video, I showed you how to use FastVPN, which is the namecheap VPN. In this video, let's see how you can set up a hotspot on Windows using your VPN. And in this case, I will be using FastVPN, but I believe this can work for any VPN that you're using. Just go down here to your network configs. I can go to open network and internet settings. And somewhere here, there should be mobile hotspot. So come here under hotspot and you can turn it on. You can turn on the mobile hotspot. If you want to change any settings, you can edit the settings for it there. Your hotspot, give it a name, give it a password. And then as for the network, you can use any available because some devices are 5 gigahertz, some are 2.4, but most devices are still 2.4. So you can just use any available and then you save. Now the next step is to make sure that the Wi-Fi is being connected through the VPN. Let's go back to, I'm looking for this, and wherever you can find this option, change adapter options, just click on that. Now this is the one with tap Windows adapter. This is the one that is bringing your internet through the VPN. I can see it has a tap Windows adapter, and that's the one that I know is bringing the VPN network into my computer. And then there's also another one that I want. I think it's this one. And if you want to know which one this is the one that will be used to dish out the internet through the hotspot. If you want to find out which one this is, it may be labeled differently. Let's just click on, you can turn hotspot off. And once you turn it off, you'll see that one disappears. The one that disappears, that's the one that you need to keep an eye out for. Let me go back to network options and I want to come here under hotspot and I want to turn it on. So once you turn the hotspot on, you'll see that this is the one that is going to give out the hotspot network. So we want this to be able to give out the hotspot network using this and not through this. This is the one that is just connected to my internet. It's just connected to my computer without the VPN. We're going to come to this and we go to properties of that. So just find out which one on your computer, but for me, I know it is this one, tap Windows that. Depending on the VPN that you're using, it could be different, but it could just be Ethernet something there. Once I click on properties, I'll just go to sharing and then allow other network users to connect through this computer's internet connection. So once I do that, I can connect it with that local area connection. Then I want to share it through this because I know this is the one that has my hotspot. So once I click OK, now the internet that is being shared now is being shared through the VPN. Now the problem that you will experience is that the IPs will not be given out automatically. And even if they're given out, there will be a problem. Let me just try to connect on my phone and see if it works. So I need the password. If I come here, go to settings, password 34. So at this point on my phone, it is telling me, and I'm using an Android phone, it is telling me that it needs to obtain, it's obtaining an IP address, and that's not going to, it will not be successful. So what you'll need to do is you'll have to give it an IP address manually. Any device that you want to connect, whether it's your TV, another phone, another computer, you'll have to give an IP address manually. So you need to find out the IP address range for the IP address range for your computer. I will do IP. So if I just do IP config, this is going to tell me my IP address range, IPv4 range, and you want to look for this connection. You remember the connection that we are giving out the internet through. You need to look for the IP address range for that. You can see they're all different. That one has a different range, and this one also has a different range. So look for the one that's providing the hotspot, and I showed you how to identify which one it is. Just disable hotspot, and if it disappears, that's the one. Then you just come down here, and IP address, you need to give it an IP address in that range. So you can see that if you come here under our hotspot, it says that we can give up to 8 IP addresses. So just give something from 192.168.137 to 1. Okay, let me just do an example on my phone. So we need to provide an IP address on the phone or on any other device that you're connecting to. So since I have an Android phone in front of me, let me just try to explain it and I hope you'll be able to follow. In the network that you're trying to connect to, in the Wi-Fi that you're trying to connect to on your phone, just click on that Wi-Fi. And then where you usually add your password, you'll see an option that says advanced options. Click on advanced options and then scroll down until you see IP settings. And then under IP settings, you'll see DHCP. So you don't use DHCP because DHCP provides the IP addresses automatically. So you're going to do it manually and then click on static. So once you click on static, you'll need to give an IP address. So for instance, in my case, you can see my IP address range should be something from around this. So I'm just going to enter 192. I'm going to enter 168.138.137. I can't even give it an IP number 2. Okay, so the next device you can give it number 3. Okay, so it will be 192.168.137.3.4.5 for the different devices until you reach .9. Okay, so the rest, gateway has automatically been added as 192.168.137.1. So anything else that you need to change here? And then as for the DNS, just put DNS as 8.8.8. 8.4 times. Okay, that is, I think that's the one for Google, the DNS server for Google. 8.8.8.8. And then you'll just click connect. And as soon as you click on connect, your phone should get internet connection or whichever device you're using. So the key is for you to add the IP addresses manually. Okay, so this is not really that difficult. Whichever device you're using, if the IP addresses are being provided by DHCP automatically, then you need to do it manually. 192.168.137.1. So the next one will be 192.168.137.2. That is for the next item you're connecting. Maybe you want to connect your TV as well to this network. You'll do 192.168.137.3. Maybe you want to connect another phone. That will be .4.5.6.7 for the different devices. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this video. And just to confirm that my network is being provided through the VPN, I will go to Google and search for what is my IP. My IP is now connected to, it's in Chicago. So what is my IP on my phone? It should tell me Chicago. And yeah, looking at my phone, it tells me that I'm in Chicago, Illinois. So that means that my network is being routed through the VPN as well on my phone. So this is important. If you are using a public Wi-Fi and you have a VPN, you can just set up a hotspot using your computer, your laptop, whatever you have. Create a hotspot and then you can connect to that hotspot. So the most important thing you have to remember is that you need to assign the IPs manually. Okay, so do IP config and then scroll down to the network. And for me, the network that's providing the Wi-Fi is that. And once I do that, I'll just come down here and I'll assign the IPs to the different devices. So just remember that the gateway, if you need to assign a gateway to any other device, the gateway will be that 198.138.1.1. That will be the gateway. And if maybe they need the subnet mask, you assign that as well. Okay, so the default gateway is .1. Any device where you need to assign a gateway, you assign .1. And if they also ask for a subnet mask, you just give that. And then the IP you just assign from 2. Going from 2, 3, 4, up to about 9, that should do it. Right, so that's how you can set up a Wi-Fi hotspot using your FastVPN on Windows. FastVPN is the namecheap VPN. I will see you in another video next time. If you have any questions, just go into the comments below and ask it. If you have any question, don't suffer in silence. Just ask in the description below. Just ask in the comments below.